Okay, this is Tom from EveryStepPhysics.com. We're going to work an actual physics problem here. Problem number 8 on my sheet, which I'll show you. And let's do it. Get to my menu. You know it's a collision or momentum problem because of the words. And so you're going to scroll down here to collision. And this decides which, from other words in the problem, what they're talking about. In this case, number 8, they're talking about a head-on collision. So we're going to choose 2, which is collides. And we're going to do head-on, which is 7. I show you the formula for the final velocity of mass 1. And mass 2, final velocity. This is the actual formula. You can see CR here, which is coefficient of restitution. That's the bounceability of a substance. And sometimes they give you that to enter into the problem or not. And if they do, then you're in good shape here. But they find this out by experimentation, and they have lists of substances about what their coefficient of restitution is. For instance, a super ball, which is the most bouncy thing on Earth, is 0.78 coefficient of restitution. It doesn't come up to 1, because if it came up to 1, that would mean that if you dropped it from 100 feet, it would bounce right back up into your hand, which gravity won't let it do it, so there's no possibility of 1. Clay is an example of coefficient of restitution of 0. And that defines whether it's a perfect elastic collision, if it has a coefficient of 1, or a perfectly inelastic collision, which is a sticking, two masses sticking and not bouncing off at all. So let's continue here. Here's a note: if an object is at rest, it's an M2 mass 2 entry here. So we have to press alpha first, so we're going to press alpha and put in the mass that's not at rest, which is the 10. We choose kilograms, that's what it says. We're going to, second mass is alpha 20, also kilograms. Initial velocity is coming at it at, 3 meters per second. We choose number 3 here, and it's going in the easterly direction, or the plus x axis direction. Choose that, and we have the initial velocity of the mass 2, which is at rest. So if it's at rest, we enter 0, alpha 0. And coefficient of restitution, if it's not given, just enter 1, alpha 1. I show you what you've entered, and you can change it if you want. This looks pretty good to me. We're going to say OK. And I gave you both final velocities of both, because they're both going to bounce off somewhat and go somewhere. And so the velocity, the final velocity of mass 1 is minus 0.1. Notice that it's going off to the left here with a minus sign. And after they hit, and here's the final velocity of mass 2. And 2 is positive, so it's going off to the right 2 meters per second. So that's the calculations. Notice on the test they do have plus 2 meters per second. And so you circle that one and get 100% on it. Pretty neat, huh? EveryStepPhysics.com. And because you know it's a collision problem or a momentum problem, you're going to scroll down to collision. If you didn't know it was that,